Hello one and all, and welcome to Seen Through Glass. Now, as I mentioned very briefly in the Q&A the other day, Trackworthy are going to be helping me get my hands on different cars whilst I'm in LA, and the first car they've let me get my hands on is this awesome and very clean Porsche 911 Carrera 4S Cabriolet. Now you might be able to tell from my face and general demeanor, but it is very early in the morning. It is 5 a.m. I have been kind of snoozing since about 2 a.m. But the good news is it means I get to go to my first ever LA car event. I'm headed to Cars and Coffee Malibu, which I'm so psyched about. But first things first, out of this car park and then Starbucks. God, I feel like a different person. Can I also just say, the sunrise that is happening behind and in front of me on this drive is bloody insane. I'm gonna fall in love with LA very quickly. Now, I'm fully expecting and preparing for myself to be one of the very first people to arrive at this event, considering I've been up for such a long time and got here so early. I think I'll be one of the first, but that is good for us. Hashtag YouTube. Because hopefully it means I can go and hang around on the street like a bit of a loser and film stuff driving in. I have no idea how this event works. I'm always happy, never sad. Glad to be the hammer when I'm scrolling on the fad. As if I wasn't in love with America enough already, I turn up this event and the very first car I see, a freaking Challenge Stradale. Left there, or if the straight edge, the vibe is the common thread. You see me bombing mics when I commandeer, but otherwise, you know I stay calm and clear. Cause that's the key to life, so take the jewels that I drop as a gift. I'm Dr. Dumas, how's my prerogative, Z? I'm still trying to take in the fact that basically the first car I spot at my first American event is a freaking Challenge Stradale. I am never leaving Los Angeles. This place is going to be freaking perfect. But I'm starting to get a lay of the ground. So behind me is the main row where most of the cars are arriving and turning in. Then we have here the actual meet where there's a waffle truck. Again, amazing. Go America. So I think, yeah, if I stay put here to begin with, kind of catch as much as I can driving in, then do a tour of the car park, and then hopefully we'll get everything leaving as well. Oh, what a fantastic event! Like mask and tape, I wear my beanie on my sleeve, make a dashing cake. I'm caking up because I've asserted my fashion straight. Lady luck pay me off from the ass and say, smashing cakes. Did a Can-Am car just roll into a breakfast meet? Did that just happen?
Drag! Go on, mate. Absolute class. What a hero. Informal torrents and no fucking chorus. Please don't bore us. Performing is a new excitement. That's the short shit. Anything fits if you force it. I am out of orbit. Somewhat important. Two cups of Tim Hortons. Skull skates here is the fits that I'm sporting. Don't forget the RDS. I get my portion. Trying to spit the hardest shit. I'm always happy. Never sad. That's what made me happy.
Okay, so it feels like there's a small break in things arriving, at least stuff slowed down. So I might as well come back into the car park and show you everything that is here.
We got the Focus RS gang here. Lads, lads, lads. They do look awesome, these cars, and it's cool to see all three in blue. Now, one thing I'm definitely keen to get more knowledgeable about during my trip is American classics. Now, I know John from Modball is after something very similar to this, a Camaro SS. I should probably call him and see if that's the kind of thing he wants. But yeah, they look awesome. I'm a big fan. I just don't know much about them. So anyone who wants to give me an education on American classics, let me know. Now, I know it's a BMW, but it's not an M4. I actually really love this little 2002, 2002. Awesome orange and really nicely restored. Now, slightly confusingly, this car has a Ferrari gear knob and a McLaren engine. So I feel like something might not add up here, but who cares? Because it looks freaking awesome. We've got the Porsche gang over here, which I'm now well and truly a member of, thanks to Trackworthy. So we've got a GTS, a blue GTS with a really nice ducktail, and then 50th anniversary wheels, love that. The Targa GTS, which I think could be the ultimate daily. I mean, literally the dream daily. Put a stupid exhaust on it and you're winning. Then, as I say, the Trackworthy Carrera 4S. And then we've got a slightly older, is that a 996 Gen 1? Oh, I'm so bad with my Porsches. C63 and Stradale.
East over the hills, I get torn, but I'm really not over the thrills. And I don't really know where it's going, but it's frills. I think of the bigger picture when it's giving me chills. Gotta lay out all my work on the trestle board. No regrets on the footsteps, let's record.
And then when you think all the good stuff's arrived, a 4GT turns out. Cool, yeah, this event is totally normal.
Springtime into summer, the big time runner. A new time gonna catch up, it's a wonder, it's a wonder, it's a wonder.
What the actual hell? I went over to take some scenic shots of some bloody American flags and an LM002 turns up. This is amazing. So if you didn't know, the LM002 was Lambo's attempt at a four-wheel drive SUV off-roading thing. I think it was based on the Hummer, or at least the Hummer program was involved somehow. The early cars had the engine from a Countach. This car in particular has an engine from a Diablo, which is just mental. They do about 4 mpg, but they are so cool and super rare. You just don't see them because I think fundamentally they were sort of slightly piggy cars, but incredible cars to drive. So yeah, awesome that has just turned up.
Dilla song won't do, from the ether to the alabaster. I won't keep you in a shallow pasture. High hills to low.
A few things that I'm picking up on this morning. The first and major thing is how varied the cars are, which is just awesome. These events happen almost every week. This one in particular, the Malibu one, I think is every 2 weeks, which again is awesome that this is the turnout every couple of weeks. But you've got everything from classic Trans Ams like this, to Challenge Stradales, to LM002s and 4GTs. It's just a wicked way to spend a Sunday morning, and it's still only like 8:30. And now, in classic car event style, it's time to get sunburned and hang around and wait for everything to leave so we can hopefully get some badass accelerations. And that's kind of it. The last few cars are rolling out behind me, as you can probably hear and see. I've absolutely loved my first proper LA car event. It's been the perfect way to start this thing. I am so jet lagged, so tired, and definitely sunburned, but it has been an awesome, awesome experience. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you have. Make sure to subscribe because this is just the start. I'm now gonna go shopping to buy some sun cream and probably some sleeping pills, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in. Hello one and all, welcome to Seeing Through Glass and welcome to Los Angeles. My LA apartment.